Hi everybody, today is March 9th, 2013. Been having microphone problems, being blocked on YouTube, etc. When it rains, it pours, right? They just don't want the information to get out. This is an interesting case. It's where law trumps common sense. Oregon Hospital reviewing facts in missing man case. This man was missing for 2 days and police and friends were searching for him. And the whole time he was in the hospital, and police called the hospital and they didn't tell him he was there and safe. A Salem hospital says it is reviewing the facts behind a decision not to inform police that a missing 81-year-old man was safe in the hospital while friends and police spent 2 days searching for him. Salem hospital spokesman Mark Galinsky told the Associated Press on Friday that if contacted by law enforcement, the hospital policy is to say whether a patient is there. Galinsky would not comment directly on the case of Thomas Dill, who was the subject of a search this week, after friends noticed he wasn't home and called police. Officers contacted area hospitals to see whether Dill was a patient, and Salem hospital officials wouldn't say, citing the Health Policies, Portability and Accountability Act, known as HIPAA, the Statesman Journal reported. They only found out because an anonymous tipster eventually told police that Dill was in Salem Hospital, and Dill has since been transferred to an adult care facility, the newspaper reported. It gets complex under HIPAA, Galinsky said, but if it's law enforcement that opens up other avenues, if we are contacted by law enforcement, we are allowed to say that the person is here. On the flip side, if we see a report that someone is missing, we would proactively contact law enforcement. Galinsky declined to say whether the policy was followed in Dill's case, but he noted the hospital is reviewing, moment by moment, the sequence of events that led to the hospital's decision not to inform the police of the man's presence. Police say the case illustrates the difficulty officers encounter when somebody goes missing. It's a cumbersome law, Salem Police Lieutenant Steve Burr said. One of the difficult things is that we have people with mental illnesses, and they could end up in a mental facility and you would never know it. They would never tell you. Friends called police Monday after noticing Dill wasn't at their apartment complex. Police were not worried about Dill's mental health, but because he is diabetic, they were concerned about the possibility that he experienced a medical emergency. Hospital spokeswoman Cheryl Horar told the Journal she couldn't speak about the specifics of Dill's case, but she said the hospital's HIPAA compliance officer is willing to talk to the police about whether we should have released that information or not. Burr doesn't think the hospital was being adversarial, but he said knowing Dill was a patient would have saved taxpayers' dollars and spared Dill's friends anxiety. The search's costs weren't immediately known. Congress passed HIPAA in 1996 and its privacy rules were implemented in 2003. Healthcare providers such as hospitals can release limited information to police, but only in certain circumstances, such as when doctors suspect child abuse or a person is the subject of a criminal investigation. Civil fines can reach $25,000 and criminal fines $250,000. So these people worried for 2 days and the hospital refused to tell anybody, even the police, that he was safe and in their care. Unbelievable. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.